thank you for these wonderful people and even our listeners right now. Father, they have come from far and near, oh Lord, to exalt you. I pray that, Lord, your word will come in power. I pray that, Lord, your word will not come to aggravate your people, but to elevate them. I reject any spirit that will take away their attention. I ask that, Lord, your Holy Spirit will come and elevate their minds so that your people will be able to absorb what you are saying in them now. Oh God, instigate through me your undiluted word to bless your people. Heal the sick, oh God. And if there's any person among us or even our listeners through the internet and through the television who are not saved, may you reveal yourself to them, name by name, one by one, to know that Jesus, you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let's read from the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 13 through 18. This is my favorite verse. I've been preaching from this text so many times with new revelations. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was believing God for a message this very morning, and this is where the Lord led me to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So shall we stand as we read the word of God? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Matthew chapter 16, verse 13 through 18. And when Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of God, I, the Son of Man, am?" And they said, "Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" And Peter, and Simon Peter, answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered and said unto him, "Blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless his word.
Amen.
And shall we be seated. As I said earlier on, some people are tired of church stuff. Some people don't feel like going to church anymore because of the disappointment they've gone through. Some people think that church stuff is fake because they cannot comprehend what church means. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm talking on the subject, the Lord's church. What church?
The Lord's church.
The Lord's church. The reason why some people don't feel like going to church anymore is that the so-called church, some of them are not depicting what the church is supposed to be. If you go to London right now, we have satanic church. They have come out to prove to the world that they are witchcraft. And it is church. There are some places that you go, everybody is naked. And it is called church. There are some places that you go, you will see people with their barracudas, with their Mercedes Benzes, with their SUVs, stripped naked, and they have a place or rooms filled with worms. And these millionaires move around in these worms. They just, you know, moving it, and the worms will be just moving around their bodies in the name of humility, and they call it church. ministers have water machines behind them, and they spray the people as spraying vegetables or spraying cocoa plants or spraying sugar canes in the name of showers of blessings. So by the time the church is over, all their hands are wet in the name of church. So we have so many types of churches. Hallelujah. Amen. We have man-made churches. Then the pastors or the bishops are kings and queens, whereby the congregation are subject to them. You have to take like 2 weeks to see a pastor. And when the pastor comes to church, as he enters the house, everybody has to stand up. And if you go to him, you have to bow before him. So the churches have become the pastors' bona fide properties. Whatever they say is final. And I say, people don't feel like going to church. They don't really understand church stuff. And we have a church that is called Canal. Canal churches. You go in there when you are preaching, somebody will be sitting by his or her boyfriend or girlfriend, and they will be kissing while the message is going on. By the time they come to church, they have their cigarettes and their Indian hands and their cocaine in their pockets. The moment the service is over, they begin to smoke. Before they enter into the church, they quench it, and it's in their stomach, it's in their pockets. They go to church, no transformation. We don't talk about holiness. You don't talk about fast. You don't talk about prayer. You don't talk about the fear of God. All we talk about is prosperity. You're going to be rich. You're going to get husband. You're going to get wife. So one man will have like 5 women. The pastor has 10. The elder has 5. The deacons have this and that. So the church has become carnal. And I say, people don't feel like going to church anymore. But beloved, I want our listeners to know that there are still some Elijahs who have not bowed to Baal. Hallelujah. Amen. There are still some churches that are serious. There are still some churches that are based on Jesus Christ. Amen. There are still some churches called the Lord's Church. Hallelujah. Amen. My wife and myself attended a church years ago. The minister was a female. I'm not against female pastors, because it is a female who converted me to the Lord. Joanna wasn't a man. Joanna was a female. Mary was a female. Deborah was a female. Esther was a female. So Jesus had females supporting his ministry. Hallelujah. The first evangelist on the face of this earth wasn't a man, but a female. What I mean is, when Jesus died and resurrected, the men were somewhere. It was the woman who went to the tomb and to see that Jesus was risen. So they went to the city and told the people about the resurrection of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. But the church I'm talking about, a female pastor, all the people in the room are all females. You don't see any man in it. And you will see how this woman is infusing pride, arrogance into the woman. And none of them is married, including the pastor herself. And it's not encouraging the woman to marry, and not encouraging the woman to respect men. Beloved, Jesus is coming. If a church is not based on the upbringing of a family, it's not the Lord's church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we have so many churches around that are not the Lord's church. they say, well, you are one of the apostles, you are Elijah, you are this, and you are that. He said, all right, you guys have been with me for a while now. Who do you think that I am? Peter rose and said, thou art Christ, the Son of the living God.
Amen.
Jesus told him that it was not revealed to you by your own intelligence, but this revelation is the gift of the discerning of the Spirit. It's a revelation. Hallelujah. Amen. For you to see that I am the Christ and the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, I will build my church. And on this rock, I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. I will build my church. Not their church. Not your church. Which means the church is the bona fide property of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So how do you see the Lord's church? You've got to have the spirit of discerning to be able to know what the Lord's church is. For the fact that they speak in tongues doesn't mean that there is a Lord's church. For the fact that the Bible is open and read doesn't mean that they speak a Lord's church. Hallelujah. For the fact that the minister is eloquent and can rattle doesn't mean that it's a Lord's church. Praise the Lord. It takes the revelation of God to discern the Lord's church. Many people go to church, they will tell you, I'm baptized. I was baptized 45 years ago. Bishop so and so baptized me. Apostle so and so baptized me. This is my baptism certificate. Your baptism certificate will not take you to heaven. It is just an ordinary paper. Like father, like son. Like pulpit, like congregation. Hallelujah. The only person who can take you to heaven is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. So you've got to be in his church. The Greek word for the church is ecclesia. Ecclesia means people who were not a body and were bound by demons. People who were cast out. I'm going to call them and make them a body. Hallelujah. That means the church, ecclesia. Those who were not a body, called to be a body. So the church is not the four walls. Hallelujah. The church is you and I. Those who were not a body, but being called to be a body. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, the Lord's church is what I'm talking about today. And how do you and I identify the Lord's church? The Lord's church has to be an ideal church. Amen. We all know the reason why your marriage is shaking is that you have taken away the juice. Are you understanding me? Be romantic. So that whenever the man is, he will remember you. Do you know that Jesus is married to the church? So Jesus wants the church to be his church. To be an ideal church. To be a supreme church. An ideal means perfect. Praise the Lord. An ideal means complete. An ideal means exemplary. An ideal means forbids me, calls me to do. May she stay, may she doesn't, come again. There are some men too. When they travel, the woman will get a broom and sweep everything away. Go, 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 go. He will not shave. He will not take his shower. His socks is here. His pants are here. What a dirty man are you? Be romantic. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Be classic. Be supreme. Are you understanding me? I'm talking about the lost church. The lost church should be a lovely church. No wonder the Sunday school is thinking about love today. We have different types of love. Hallelujah. Amen. If it is used in a proper way, the lost church should be a loving church. Amen. Amen. Loving what? Loving the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. David said, it is your word have I put in my heart so that I don't sin against you. Are you understanding me? We have so many synthetic churches. They have Bibles. And you know what they do? These so-called ministers won't pray. They won't study the word of God. Sunday morning, they put on their jackets, coats, gowns, name it. And then you put so many stuff on them. When you see them, you get scared. You cannot even go near to them. And when they come, they'll put the Bible on their forehead, on their head. Because they didn't study. They'll say, church, we are here today. The Holy Ghost is going to give us a word. So I'm going to put my hand here. And when my hand touches, it's what God is giving us this morning. So he put his hand there. And what up right now, you know, my hand is in the middle of the Bible. And there's no word there. What do you do? Are you understanding me? Never you sit under any so-called man of God or a woman of God who does not have time for the Bible. Amen. Are you understanding me? Amen. Some people go to church and say you are a deacon, you are an elder. You allow them to preach 1, 2, 3. They have confidence in the people. People have confidence in them. Today, tomorrow, they start church. And they begin to baptize people in the bathtub. By the time they baptize you in the bathtub, you are red. Are you understanding me? Just be wise. So many men are claiming to have power to let women get pregnant. Now what they are doing is that they put salt in water and they will wash the under of women. Washing somebody's wife's private part. Are you understanding me? So many women also, you are anointed with the oil and they will say, so far, see her, bishop, under there. They will direct you to go there because they are deceived. Are you understanding me? The lost church should be a loving church. Loving what? Loving the word of God. Knowledge is power. And power is influence. Hallelujah. The Sadducees and the Pharisees weren't able to confront Jesus. They weren't able to put Jesus down because Jesus was an intelligent personality. He knew the word of God because he was the word himself. Hallelujah. If you and I will study the word of God, we will grow into maturity. Because Jesus grew in knowledge, Jesus grew in stature, Jesus grew in wisdom, Jesus grew in power. Why? Because the word of God was in him. So when the devil came to confront Jesus, what did he use to defeat him? He used the word of God. Hallelujah. Are you understanding me? People don't love Sunday school anymore. They think Sunday school is for children. They think they are above it. They will never have Bible studies. They will study the word of God. And they don't have time for the word of God. Beloved, I'm talking about the lost church. The lost church is a loving church. Loving what? Loving the word of God. Timothy told, Paul told Timothy about something. And as I read it, I was very happy. 2 Timothy 4. This is what the Lord used Paul to tell Timothy. He said, and thy sisters have I sent to Ephesus. Or if you read from the beginning, from 9, do thy diligence to come shortly after me. For Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed unto Thessalonica. Christians to Galatia, Titus unto Dalmatia. Only Lucas with me. Take Mark and bring him with thee, for he is profitable unto me for the ministry. And Tychicus, or however you pronounce it, have I sent to Ephesus. This is what I'm looking for. 13. Declare that I left Troas and Troas of Caphus. When thou comest, bring with thee and the books, but especially the parchments. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The books and especially the parchments. This is Paul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Years ago, we had a ministers' conference and we have a key Bible that we read. And one guy wanted to build a citywide church. He came from one of the regions in our country and came to where we live in the city where we set a church. And this guy didn't like anything about theology. When he sees them like theologian, he doesn't even want to see you. He didn't have time to do any research. And all he said was that the Bible that he has in his written in his language, that alone is enough for him. So when he prays, he can make it. I look at him and say, my brother, if you don't take care, you will survive in the ministry. But 3 to 4 years later, I asked about him. Where is he? They say, oh, he's gone. He left the people and ran away. Why? Because he wasn't ready to do what? To research, to study, to have time for the word. Fasting and prayer is good. Recently, we went for 31 days. But to tell you the truth, if you fast and pray alone, you can go to hell without books and the parchments. Are you understanding me? The books and the parchments are what? The word of God. It enlightens you. It shows you the way. It empowers you. Praise the Lord. How could your faith be strengthened? The Bible says faith cometh by hearing. Hearing what? Hearing the word of God. You've been a Christian for 21 years or 32 years. You've not even read one chapter from the Bible. Anywhere you go, it is the so-called pastor who recites some stuff for you and pray for you and you leave. You are preparing for hell. You better change your mind. Get your own Bible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A Bible that you can understand. Get your notebook. Get some concordances. Strong concordance. I can, you know, recommend that for you. Praise the Lord. Get some books. Faith books. And read. Have time for your word. The word of God. Don't just get up and do a sign of cross and run home and run to work. Are you understanding me? If you are sick, you get up in the morning. You think the sickness will go? It won't go. It will never go. You have to go into the way. Jesus said, Isaiah said, by his strength, we were healed. Are you understanding me? Then you tackle God by his own way. The Father, you have said in your way that by your strength we were healed. So Lord, heal me by your way. See, when people don't like you, they will use anything to antagonize you. They will use anything to bring you down. Are you understanding me? But beloved, let's support one another. And let's help one another. And let's love one another. That is church. Praise the Lord. I don't want to take your time because time is fast spent. So I think I'm going to stop here. And if Jesus tarries, we'll continue another time. But I do believe that somebody is blessed this morning. I just want to expose to you what the lost church is. Amen. So that no minister, anybody, you know, come and deceive you. Are you understanding me? So you can go to heaven. Shall we pray? Yeah.